All right, this is for Algebra 2, Lessons 3A, and I did a little bit from B, numbers 13 through 16. So these problems right here is what we're going to be looking at. Before we start that, I just want to do a quick review because sometimes these rules can get crazy. What is the difference when you add versus when you multiply and you're dealing with exponents? First of all, you can only add if your variables are exactly the same. So this is an x to the first, and this is an x to the first, so I can add this. So this would be 5x. Okay, you notice my variable didn't change. I say, how many x's do I have? I cannot technically add these because my variable is not exactly the same. This was an x to the first, this is an x to the third, so this would be my answer. I can't even simplify it any further. So when you add, variables have to be exactly the same. You can multiply anything you want together. So in this case, I've got 3 times 2 is 6. And when you multiply and you have the same base, they're both x's, you add the exponents. So this would be x to the second. Okay. Same thing here. They're not like. I couldn't add them, but I can multiply them. So it gets 6x to the, this is a first, and 1 plus 3 is 4. So that would be my answer here. So multiply anything you want, but you can only add or subtract like terms. All right, so when I come down here, this is 13A, and I'm gonna do real quick here these first few problems just to be, you know, just to hopefully help somebody along here. If you've got the same thing over the same thing and you're dividing, they technically cancel. So those are gone. You could also think about that when you divide, you subtract exponents. So you would have 3 minus 3, so you would have an x to the 0. But remember, what is anything to the 0 power? It's 1. So like right here, that right there is 1. Love it. So also remember, I like to get rid of my negative exponents. So since this guy has a negative exponent, I'm going to bring him to the top. So I would have 2 y to the second right there. You have an x to the first on the top, x to the second on the bottom. Those cancel. So I would have an 8. This is a y to the third on the top, y here. Subtract your exponents when you divide. That would give me y to the second. Now, by the way, those are like terms because my variable is exactly the same. Let's see what we get over here, though. I have a 7. I have more x's in the bottom. I would be like, how many more? So I would write it like this. There's one more x in the bottom. 4 minus 3 is 1. So you could write it like that. And I have a y to the second on the bottom. So that's that term right there. So, obviously, I can't do anything with this guy. It does say write all the variables on one line. Okay, let me take care of that here in a minute. This is 2 minus 8, so that would be negative 6 y to the second plus 7 over xy squared. This would be my preferred answer. If you're following the directions and you would want to write it all on one line, it would look like this. These are positive exponents. If I put them on the top, they become negative exponents. So this would be x to the negative 1, y to the negative 2. So you can move around your variables. If they're positive and you put them on the top, the exponent changes signs, okay, or vice versa. So that would be the answer for that one. Okay, let's look at this one real quick. Again, I don't like to deal with negative exponents. So he has a negative exponent, so I would be writing this like this. A, x to the third, and then I'd bring him to the top, which would be x to the third. That would give me a, x to the sixth, because when you multiply, you add your exponents. Okay? Minus, again, I would be bringing him to the top, so that would be b, x to the third. They have positive exponents. I would leave them alone. He is negative, so I'd bring him to the top, which would make the exponent positive. So this would give me b to the second, because when you multiply, you add your exponents, x to the third. Definitely not like terms there. Plus, okay, let me see what we got here. All right, I have more b's in the bottom. Now, honestly, if you're in my class, this is the way I would write this. I have this guy right here. I have more x's in the bottom. I would say I have one more x in the bottom, so you could do it like that. Okay, think about it. This is a 1 up here. 2 minus 1 is 1, and there's more in the bottom, so it stays in the bottom. Same thing with the b's. This is b to the first. 2 minus 1 is 1, and there were more of them in the bottom, so it goes in the bottom. So I would write it like that, and that would be my final answer right there. This would be it. There are no like terms here at all. So I'm done. If you're going to try to write this on one line, just in case, okay, it would look like this. This guy right here, that's the same thing as a x to the negative 1, b to the negative 1. They're to the first power. They're positive. If you bring them to the top, they're going to have a negative exponent. I don't like them. I don't like negative exponents, so I would probably write it like that. All right. Next one right here, I would write this as 3a. I'm going to put my b on the bottom because he has negative exponents. Right here, those all have positive exponents right here, so I'm going to leave them alone. My a has a negative exponent, so I bring him to the top. And the b is already positive, so I'm going to leave him sitting right there. And then this guy has a negative exponent, so I bring him to the top. So there we go. He's positive. Leave him alone. Now, if you can simplify it all, that would be great. I notice this is the same and this is the same. They have the exact same variables. They have an a over b. I have 3 here and 3 here. That would give me 6a over b. These b's right here are going to cancel. I have a b to the first on top and a b to the first on bottom. They're gone. This is going to give me 13a to the third. Because, when you multiply, add exponents. I love this answer. This would be my preferred answer right here. If you're trying to write it on one line, this is b to the first. You would want to bring him to the top. That would be 6a b to the negative 1 plus 6a to the third. Okay. All right, let's look at this one. First of all, I see a y to the 0, so I'm like, you're out of here because you're a 1 right there. So I don't even have to deal with him. I personally would write this like this. I see that negative exponent, so I'm going to take him and I'm going to throw him to the bottom. Most people, they don't deal very well when there's a bunch of negatives and they have to add and subtract negatives. So that's one reason I do that. This guy right here is negative, so I'm going to put him to the bottom, which makes the exponent positive. And this all stays on the top. They all have positive exponents. And realize that's 6 to the first, x to the first, y to the first. That's what all of those are saying. So right here I have 3y to the second. There are more x's on the bottom. Notice 3 minus 2 is 1. So, and it's greater on the bottom, so it's going to stay on the bottom. 2 times 6 is 12. Remember, multiplication is commutative. I can multiply in any order. So multiply your numbers together. I have x to the second, because that's an x to the first, y to the first, so you're adding. And notice here, I've got more y's on the bottom. 3 minus 1 is 2. So I like this answer. They're definitely not alike, so I can't add them, so that would be my final answer. If you would want to write this on one line, you would have to bring him to the top, which would make that x to the negative 1. You would bring this guy to the top, which would make it y to the negative 2. But I don't like negative exponents. So that's that one. All right. Let's see. Let's do one more here. I don't know that we really want to do all of these, do we? Huh? Okay, look right here. Gross. I personally would want to rewrite this. If you wanted to go ahead, these have positive exponents. I could go ahead and combine that. 12 and 6 is what, 18? So I'd have r to the 18. I would want to put him on the bottom. If I put him on the bottom, do you see that's an r to the third on the bottom right there, which is going to give me r to the fourth. And this is a negative exponent, so I'd bring him to the top. So I've got that right there so far. Now I'd want to go ahead and simplify this again, but I'll do that here in just a second. This, he's one. Nobody even cares about him. I would take him, because he has a negative exponent, and I would put him on the bottom to make that exponent positive. So look what you have here. You have an r to the third on the top, and you have an r to the third on the bottom. Remember, the same thing over the same thing is 1. Or you could think, what's 3 minus 3? 0. And r to the 0 is 1. Okay. So my final answer here, if you're dividing, you subtract exponents, and I believe 18 minus 4 is what, 14, s to the third plus 1. Don't forget your 1 right there. I love that. And I like this too, make all exponents positive. Much better instructions there than previously. Okay, here we go. Let's do this again. Negative exponent. I personally would take him and I'd move him to the top. So that x to the first is going to go on the top. I would take him. He's got a negative exponent. I'd move him to the top. So look what I have here. I have an x to the third, x to the first, which is x to the fourth, y to the fourth, because we're adding my exponents. Plus 8. Remember, I have 5. This is x to the first. Subtract your exponents. That would be x to the fourth, y to the fourth. Because again, 5 minus 1 is 4. Minus, now this one's tricky. And by the way, I do notice these are like terms because my variables are exactly the same. So, woohoo! I'm going to get to add those here in just a minute. This is tricky right here. That has a negative exponent, so I'm going to write that 3 on the bottom. So it's a 3 to the positive first. I have more x's on the top. 4 minus 2 is 2. 5 minus 2 is 3. So that's that term right there. So final answer, I can't do squat with him because he is not the same as these. So I would have 10, x to the fourth, y to the fourth. When you add and subtract, you do not change your variables at all. That's only when you multiply and divide. Minus x squared, y to the third, over 3. That would be your answer right there. Okay, he's won. Down you go. So look what I have, 16, b to the fourth. All right, this is going to give me b to the 7th on the bottom. Do you see that? 2 plus 5 is 7, so that gives me b to the 7th down there. And so I have more b's on the bottom. 7 minus 4 is 3, and there's more of them on the bottom, so I'd write it like that. Definitely not like, okay? Minus 4a. That's your answer right there. You can't do squat with that. Okay. Oh, I just love this. Look at him. He's 1. He's out of there. Don't care about him at all. I have right here, I honestly would put him on the bottom, so I'm going to do this. I'm going to draw, make this a fraction right here. I'm going to take that a to the negative 2, and I'm going to put him on the bottom. I'm going to take that b to the negative 3. It's a negative exponent, not a negative number. It's a negative exponent, so I'm going to take him, and I'm going to put him on the bottom. So my answer here, I'm going to move this. Sorry, scribbling. I've got 2. 6 minus 2 is 4, so I have a to the 4th. C to the third over B to the third plus, okay, same thing here. I see this negative exponent, so I'm going to like, I'm going to take you and I'm going to put you on the bottom. So instead of a negative 3, it's a positive 3. Remember when you multiply, you add exponents, so that'd be C to the third, A to the fourth over B to the third. I like this problem. These are like terms. Notice this is a to the fourth, a to the fourth. C to the third, c to the third. All over b to the third. These are like terms. And there's one of these. So 2 plus 1 is 3. Technically, it should be in alpha order. So I'm going to write a to the fourth, c to the third, all over b to the third. And that's it. That's my lovely answer.